के नई दिल्ली जहां विदेश मंत्री सुषमा स्वराज इस कार्यक्रम को संबोधित कर रही हैं।
योर वर्ड्स दे हैव इंटरप्रेटेड इट। वी हैव ऑलवेज लुक्ड अपॉन ब्रिक्स एज अ टेम्पलेट फॉर अ न्यू अप्रोच टू ग्लोबल गवर्नेंस इन द 21st सेंचुरी। आर फाइव नेशंस रिप्रेजेंट द वॉइस ऑफ द चेंजिंग वर्ल्ड एंड आर अप्रोच टू द ग्लोबल इश्यूज signifies a convergence across different continents on the opportunities and challenges that await us. 9 months ago, when India took over the chair of BRICS, we laid out an ambitious agenda premised on the theme of building responsive, inclusive and collective solutions. We unveiled plans to raise the level of our engagement across sectors. As we approach the end of the chairmanship, our record speaks for itself. A total of 115 BRICS events have been held. This includes 2 parliamentary meetings, 15 ministerial meetings, and 56 meetings of senior officials and working groups. We have also organized 27 workshops and seminars, 3 track 2 and 5 business events. Through each of these meetings, not only have we raised the number of our cross-cutting interactions, but we have also sought to focus on the output from the various discussions. I myself have been pleased to inaugurate some events and to meet with the participants of these. Each workshop and seminar, each conclave and conference have in turn renewed and re-energized our sectoral engagements. The networks of connections that have been built and the partnerships that have been conceived in their wake will assume a life of their own in the days to come. India this time brought a practical, informal and effective approach as the chair to the BRICS. Let me share with you that at Goa, this was recognized and appreciated by the other nations. It was reflected not only in the quality of the discussions at the summit, but in the activities preceding it. Essentially, we took the BRICS outside the conference room and endeavored to instill it in popular thinking. To do that, we partnered organizations and activities across the breadth of civil society. We were conscious that the BRICS not only represents more than 1/3 of humanity, but is also a powerful voice of hope for future generations. It is for this reason that in line with Prime Minister Modi's vision, we have sought to lay particular emphasis on the people-to-people linkages that will bring our nations closer. So, a unique aspect of the 115 meetings was that they were not only held in Delhi and our major cities, but through the length and breadth of India. This was the case from the BRICS Film Festival to the Under-17 football tournament, from the Friendship Cities Conclave and Urbanization Forum to the Handicraft Artisans Exchange Program and Digital Conclave, from the Young Diplomats Forum to the Youth Summit and Young Scientists Conclave. This way, India's chairmanship has sought to build a new constituency amongst our peoples and our youth, a building BRICS, if you will, for the future. Friends, from its very inception, BRICS has focused on issues of development and economic growth, addressing challenges confronting the world and encouraging the emergence of a more equitable and sustainable global architecture. Initially, the deliberation of BRICS concentrated more on economic and financial issues. But over the years, it has broadened to cover larger global issues, even as it has promoted the creation of BRICS institutions and mechanisms. Key initiatives like a BRICS rating agency that can complement the New Development Bank, or the Railways Research Network, and an agriculture research platform that will allow us to leverage our specific strengths for mutual benefit are tangible goals that we believe can take the group forward. There has always been an overarching political context for the BRICS meetings, which essentially underlines that a serious global discourse cannot be the preserve of a few countries with a narrow agenda. The 8th BRICS summit represented a further advancement in terms of the breadth and focus of its discussions. While our economic engagement and political cooperation remain key factors, there is a sharper realization that global development and prosperity is very much dependent on continued peace and security. Terrorism is universally recognized as a key threat to stability, progress, and development. Consequently, it featured strongly in the conference narrative and its eventual outcome. Indeed, what we saw was not just an understanding of the dangers posed by terrorism to the economic aspirations of the world, but a growing recognition that this has now become a truly global challenge that the international community can only ignore at its peril. There is a developing consensus that it cannot be business as usual. We must be prepared to extract costs for those who sponsor and support terrorists, who provide them sanctuary, and who, despite their own claimed victimhood, continue to make the false distinction between good and bad terrorists. BRICS has always been global in its approach, and today there is no bigger global challenge than state-sponsored and state-protected terrorism. The selection of BIMSTEC as the outreach group for the Goa summit is also worth reflecting upon. Members of BIMSTEC, Bhutan, Bangladesh, India, Nepal, Sri Lanka, and Thailand, today represent the polar opposite of a terrorism promoting polity. They are focused on improving the quality of life of their people, on skills and employment, on education and health, and on the quality of governance and the deepening of democracy. These are nations who are actively promoting connectivity, cooperation, and context amongst themselves. Their interface with the BRICS has a message in itself. This is that a world changing in a positive direction, as reflected by the BRICS, has its regional expression in a community like BIMSTEC that is able to visualize a prosperous collective future. There cannot be a greater contrast with those who reject even trade and connectivity for political reasons. One aspect of the BRICS engagement is the interaction of our respective national media. As interpreters and communicators, all of you play that crucial role of not merely keeping us informed, but in influencing opinions and shaping outcomes. Through your work, we are reminded of our shared goals and our common challenges. And on account of your always critical eye, we are mindful of the opportunities that remain, of the paths that remain untraveled. So I'm certain that the panel discussions that will follow today will no doubt be an enriching source of debate and discussion as we go forward. Ladies and gentlemen of the media, in Goa, we have strengthened the institutional foundation of the BRICS and set it on the path of seeking collective solutions. This will not only help propel the BRICS nations forward, but also be a voice of hope, peace, and prosperity for the entire world. Now, over to you to carry this message as far and as wide as possible. I'm sure the BRICS Media Forum will mark an important milestone in this shared journey of ours. Thank you.